Okay, we are Oisin Scully.
I'm Oisin Scully.
And I'm Sean Scully, and we're going to visit my studio, right?
Of course.
And Oisin, who knows more about my work than anybody in the world, is going to ask a couple of questions. Right, love?
Yeah.
Okay, what's the first question?
Well, what is the most recent painting you've made?
Good question. That one there, which we'll walk over to now, is the most recent painting. This little one.
This little one?
Yeah, painted on copper. And
very nice one. Has all the basic colours in it. Yellow,
yeah.
Red and blue.
That's right, yellow, red, blue. And you know, a guy called Barney Newman made a famous painting called Who's Afraid of Red, Yellow and Blue? And the answer is not me. And it's got black in it too.
Yeah.
So you see you've got the copper coming through. And what's going on here is this colour gets made on the painting by mixing, you know, overpainting.
Yeah, if you paint and mix the colours.
Yeah.
Layers.
You get different things happening that you can't predict, which is what's so beautiful about painting, of course.
I've also noticed this one looks a lot kind of like a big one of that, because it has the same red, yellow and blue.
Yeah, because I've made a lot of red, yellow and blue. So once I make a lot of one colour, then I just use it, you know, I get in the habit of using it.
Also has the same colour down here.
Yeah.
As, not really actually.
No? But
no, that, it's quite different from the other.
Yeah.
Bottom colour.
I love to use pink. You know who else used a lot of pink?
Okay.
Picasso.
Oh.
Which I think is so strange. Because pink is an odd colour that I don't really understand, but I use it anyway. Now this is an important painting for me because these paintings are painted during the time of COVID.
Mm.
And the metaphor is that the window, which points to the future, is blacked out. So we have no future. Or we have an uncertain future, or we don't know what it is.
Yes.
And it's set into a romantic, kind of romantic painting. So you've got, it's dialectical. One thing is attacking the other. Like COVID is attacking our life, isn't it?
Yeah.
And what else is attacking our life, do you think, that begins with the letter T? Followed by the letter R, followed by the letter U.
True.
True. Tra. Tra.
Tra.
Tra. M.
Okay, you just said.
Trump.
Oh, yes.
We've got a terrible president in the United States that we're trying to get rid of. And it's at the same time as COVID, so hopefully COVID, the bugs, are going to assist us to get rid of the fat guy.
Yeah.
And repair the spirit of America. So that's kind of what these paintings are dealing with. Mm. They're a little bit political as a metaphor.
Well, so. I particularly like this painting, but I would like you to explain a bit more about this one.
Well, the interesting thing about this painting, which you seem to like less than this one.
No, I like that one a lot too.
This one?
Because yeah.
This one's your painting.
Really?
It's called War Red Oisin. Anything that's got your name on it is yours or dedicated to you. You know, and I do that every year.
Actually, I like each of them for a different reason. I like this one because of its different colors. A lot of the colors are warm, but then you have these kind of colder colors like black and then just a big flying blue there. It's very kind of
very aggressive tonally. And this one is no exception. And then all this stuff between is the earlier attempts.
Yeah.
So it's kind of like a wall with holes in it, or gaps in it.
Interesting.
Yeah, and this one is unusual because of the color, right?
I actually really particularly like the mix of these colors.
And here
I like the mix of colors in both, but I like mix of colors for a different reason in each.
And what about this? This is the pink again.
Yeah, just as shown in there.
Yeah. And do you like that little painting at the end? That was the first one I did when we came back here this summer. That little wall.
It's an interesting little small one.
You know what I like also? I like it as an object, because the painting is an object. Look at this. This is really old, the stretcher. Look.
An old inside.
It was made by my brother.
Wow.
You know, your invisible uncle.
I never even met him.
It's right. He's the invisible man.
You know, it kind of does remind me of something very strange. It has the pink again, the red, the black, orange.
Yeah.
And you know what I noticed?
What?
It's that it looks a bit like a mix of some of your other paintings.
Yeah,
for example, it has the pink from that one and that one.
Yeah.
The one with the big black window and the one with a lot of blue and yellow.
Yeah.
But it also reminds me of the red and orange because of War Red Oisin.
Nice. Yeah. So, War Red Oisin was made last year and I left it here. It's one of my favorite paintings in the room, of course, because it's named after you. And that painting, has some of the color I used in this painting. So I make a continuation.
Well, I would like to say my favorite painting out of the four, five we saw. Well, I liked all of them, but truly my favorite is War Red Oisin and that blue one over there. They both are just really nice paintings to me.
Okay, so here's a big room at the end, you know, where I put things to think about. You know, I leave them there to think about.
I walk in and
I've got done.
Been in there many times.
Yeah, I know. It also doubles as a Lego playroom.
Well, yeah.
This is an older
room. I keep getting
broken. This is an older room. And here is one painting from the 80s.
Wow.
That one. And this is called Shadow Line. It's a painting, it's got a step in it.
Yeah.
What do you think about that?
This is a very interesting one because I've seen you make quite a lot of ones where there's just kind of a hole in the middle and you put another piece of a painting with the other one, the black window one.
Right.
This one is very interesting because you actually have two of it. There's that piece there, that piece there, that there's four parts to this painting.
Right.
That are all separate.
Yeah.
But all the same.
Yeah, so this this painting is trying to unify itself and pull itself apart at the same time. So it's got a lot of disjuncture in it, which is what typifies my paintings of the 80s. Before you were born, I made this painting.
I know.
Isn't that nice? I still got it, and it's got a window in it.
True.
Yeah, window's a big thing in my work. And here, next to that window, which I think is so interesting, after what we just said, is a recent painting that I made last year. Another, and it's, what is it on? Yeah, it's on copper. So you can see how much I like windows, because I'm making a painting and I hang it next to a window. Let's see if anybody's inside, shall we? Come in. Somebody said come in. What do you think? Shall we go in?
How? What I find is interesting is that it's funny how there's these pieces of copper leaking through.
Yeah.
I like that.
Yeah, it reestablishes the relationship between the paint and the ground. That was a real minimalist thing.
Still looks wet.
Yeah. And this one here, this is one from maybe 15 years ago. It's a triptych. And it's made of three separate panels.
That's
again.
An interesting one. Yeah. More separates.
Let's go and look at the Doric paintings, which continue that idea.
What I say is that these three really look similar but different at the same time. And something else very interesting about them is that they're apart. And they could be together, but they're still apart because they fit perfectly together.
Yeah, and what about this one? That's how they end up.
It's the mirror.
I know.
It's mirrored.
That's it.
Oh my God. It's like, this is apart and this is together.
That's how they, yeah, that's how they get shown.
I really like that. Thanks.
And why do you think they're apart? Why is, why?
Uh-huh. I'm not sure.
Well, when I paint them, I have to paint them apart so that I get that cut edge.
And then they go together.
Yeah, so in these paintings, you've got two edges. And again, it's this dialectical idea of the brutal and the poetic in the same painting.
Yeah.
So you have soft edges on that, but they're cut.
Yeah. And sharp edges on that.
Yeah, and that's it. So, should we say anything else to the folks before we say goodbye?
Well, yeah. Out of the different rooms that we went through,
yeah,
I've liked all of them. This is interesting, and apart and together, sharp and soft.
Yeah.
And then also the room before, it's very interesting with its different paintings, and the one that has three parts, the one that was made before I was born, and the other one right next to the window. Then also all the way at the very beginning with red wall of sheen and that blue one. It's just, and all the other paintings, black hole in the black window,